Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to add hieroglyphics and carved text into an ancient Egyptian wall. I provided this stone texture for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. In addition, I provided a link to a hieroglyphic-like font called Pegypta. The lowercase looks like this, and the same characters in uppercase looks like this. You can mix and match if you like. I also provided this font derived from Egyptian hieroglyphics called Meroitic Hieroglyphics. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial on how to do this. I provided that link as well. This document is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Open your horizontal type tool and open Pegypta. I'll make the size 100 points, sharp, center alignment, and black for the color. Type out your text. I'm using all lowercase for this example. To increase or decrease the amount of space between lines, go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Highlight the bottom line and slide the baseline shift to the left or right. Then close the character panel. To center your text on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl-A on Windows or Command-A on a Mac. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command-D. Reduce the fill to 0%. Click on the FX icon and choose Bevel and Emboss. Make the style Inner Bevel, the technique Chisel Hard, the direction Down, and the size 43 pixels. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 68 degrees and the altitude 32 degrees. Make the opacity 100%. Click Drop Shadow. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle minus 139 degrees. Make the spread 3%, then click OK. Next, we'll add the lines above and below our text that will separate the text from the hieroglyphic icons. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Pencil tool and make the point size 15, the hardness 100%, the blend mode normal, and the opacity 100%. Click View and make sure Rulers is checked. If it isn't, just click on it. Click on the ruler at the top and drag down a guideline below your text. If you don't see it, press Ctrl or Command H. Drag down another guideline to above the top of your text. This will be our guides as we draw the lines. Place your cursor on the line to the left of your document and draw across it all the way to the right. Repeat this on the other guideline. To hide the guidelines, press Ctrl or Command H. Reduce the fill to 0%. Go to the FX icon and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the effects next to the lines layer. Notice this layer now has a copy of all the effects. Next, we'll add the hieroglyphic icons. Open the Horizontal Type tool and click above the line. Open your list of fonts and click Meroitic Hieroglyphics. Make the point size 75 and choose Left Alignment. Type out letters to make a chain of hieroglyphics. Open your Move tool to move it. Go to the FX icon and drag a copy of it next to the hieroglyphics. Then reduce the fill to 0. Because the point size of the hieroglyphics is smaller than our text, will reduce the distance of its drop shadow to compensate for its smaller size. Double-click on Drop Shadow to see it in the Layer Style window. Reduce the distance to 3 pixels. Then click OK. Make a copy of the hieroglyphics by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag the copy straight down. Press T to open your Type Tool and highlight the line. Type out mostly different letters that you did for the top line. We're ready to create the lighting, but first we need to make a composite snapshot of the image. Make the top layer active and press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command-J. Hide the copy and make the original active. Go to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects. If your lighting effects is unavailable or grayed out, it's most likely due to one of the reasons I listed in the video description. The lighting effects window will open. If you don't see the ring guides on your document, press Ctrl or Command H. Make sure Spotlight is chosen. If it isn't, click on this icon to open your list of lights and choose it. Make the ambiance 15, the intensity 69, the hot spot 91, and the gloss -100. Click on the scale width and pull it out to the upper right corner. Click on the scale length and pull it out to widen the spotlight. To reposition it, click inside and drag the spotlight up and over. Click on the scale width at the lower left and pull it out further. Continue to manipulate the scale width and length, as well as the hot spot angle, to make it look like the sun is shining through an opening above your hieroglyphic wall. Don't be concerned with the blown out brightness on the upper right corner. We'll fix that in a moment. Click OK. Make the top layer visible and active. Click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the top layer. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Open your brush tool and make the size 1100 pixels and the hardness 0%. Click once over the upper right corner to reveal that corner of the composite snapshot copy through the layer mask. Let's make our image a bit brighter. Press Ctrl or Command L to open the Levels window. Drag the input white to where the histogram starts to climb. Then click OK. For the last step, we'll make the color a bit more vibrant. Click on the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Vibrance. Increase it to 75. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.